Kidambi Srikanth up against the player from Hong Kong, China, Cheuk Yiu. Well, this, I can tell you, is right at the top of the third quarter of the draw, and the defending champion and reigning world champion, Kunlawu Twidasan, safely through to the second round, having beaten young Dane Magnus Johannesson in the first round. So the world champion awaits the winner of the match we're about to watch. In fact, Kidambi Srikanth has been in two finals here at his home event, the India Open. Well, just listen to the roar from the home fans. Former world number one, Kidambi Srikanth. Olympic quarter-finalist, Commonwealth Games silver medalist, and World Championship silver medalist. World Championship silver medalist in Huelva in 2021. Lost out in the final to Lo Ken Yu of Singapore. Lo Ken Yu, who was the beaten finalist at this event 2 years ago, sadly had to withdraw injured, not injured, ill. Has been at several withdrawals after last week in Malaysia. This is Cheuk Yiu making his fifth appearance here at the India Open. And his previous four appearances, he's never got past the first round. So if you're a fan of Cheuk Yiu, that might be a little concerning, but I can tell you this will be a fourth meeting between these two particular players. And of the previous three encounters, Cheuk Yiu has won two of them. The last two, in fact, the last time they met was the second round of the Swiss Open last year.
Black is
two
the ball.
Straight games.
You on the toss. This side. Will you serve or receive?
So Cheuk Yiu wants to choose ends. Sensible, yes, everybody's wrapped up warm because it is very chilly conditions here in Delhi. So he's going to turn 31 next month, Kidambi Srikanth, born in Ravulapalem, and that's in Andhra Pradesh. He is a former world number one, as I was telling you, one precious week from the 12th of April 2018. 1 week on the top of the world rankings. But went down one place with the rankings published yesterday, down to 25. And would you believe this is his 12th consecutive appearance here at the India Open. His first was back in 2012. He lost in the qualifying. His opponent, Cheuk Yiu, is 27, born in Hong Kong, China. And he, like his opponent, went down one place on the world ranking published yesterday, down to 18, but did spend a total of 12 weeks across five different spells at number 14 on the rankings. Two finals for Lee last year, the Thailand Open, and the event in Saarbrücken. The Thailand Open was a 500 event, the Saarbrücken event a 300. This, of course, is a 750, which is the second highest tier of tournament
ready to play
on the World Tour. So, umpire from Sri Lanka, and service judge from Bangladesh. Pulela Gopichand with the hat on, and Asya Parupalli from the Commonwealth Games gold medalist also on the coaching bench. Kidambi Srikanth, the former world number one, the former winner of the India Open back in 2015, where he beat a certain Mr. Victor Axelsen in the final. In fact, he played Victor Axelsen in both of his finals here in the India Open. Lost to Axelsen in 2019. But he had a pretty torrid time last year, did Kidambi Srikanth, Steen. He played a total of 21 individual tournaments and had 17 first or second round losses.
Yeah, last four tournaments, I guess, in a year, he lost the first tournament, first round. So, encouraging for him to start the year by surviving, beating Jonathan Christie last week in Malaysia Open. That was a bit of a surprise to me, but playing conditions in Malaysia pretty much like Srikanth loves it.
What, the faster conditions?
Fast playing conditions. Here we have two players that basically are like two fish on land in this week here, because they love fast playing conditions. They're really good at playing in drifty conditions, loves to attack. It's got good net game. But this will be a really exciting match because they're similar style. None of them like these playing conditions too much.
That's a good point. They both like to attack, no doubt about it. Vicious spin, and it actually went over. Reached the final of five Super Series events back in 2017, winning four of them, two of them back to back. The Indonesia Open and the Australia Open, and then the Denmark Open, and the following week the French Open. That was quite extraordinary, wasn't it?
So double back to back.
Yes. Yeah. Three tournaments in a row, because he was in the final of the Singapore Super Series event, then went to Indonesia, won the tournament, and then flew down to Australia and won that one too.
Weren't that many Super Series tournaments at that time, so reaching five finals.
Yeah.
That's a really good job.
Yeah, there was only 12 a year, weren't there?
Yeah, I think so. I saw his match against Jonathan Christie last week. I can't recall whether you also saw it, Joe.
I did. We were commentating together.
And I think Kashyap did a fantastic job in supporting Srikanth in that match. He was behind up until 17-14 down in the second game. That's when he turned it around.
Yeah, it was amazing. Yeah, because there was no Gopichan coaching in that particular match. I think Gopichan was there last week, wasn't he?
I don't think I saw him.
Okay.
Deception does the trick.
Yeah, that's beautifully constructed rally from Kidambi.
There it is.
Difficult to tell, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Service over. 6-9.
Wait. Coach, do not coach when the players are in the serve.
Okay, so Wong Chong got a warning whilst Kishap was doing the exact same on the opposite side.
Nice from the Cheuk Yiu.
7-9.
Champion. Oh, my goodness, he's started this first round match well. Start to this first round encounter by Kidambi Srikanth.
Service over. 8-11.
I should think that the Hong Kong team had him more or less covered because, as far as I recall, he lost to Hong Kong in the second round last week.
That is absolutely correct.
Cheuk Yiu.
Going right.
Yeah.
And he was on the rally anyway.
I thought for a while here that Lee Cheuk Yiu had come out a little bit more positive following the interval, trying to control the rallies a bit more, but.
Obviously from Lee Cheuk Yiu. Because that was lovely aggression from Kidambi.
Good placement.
Oh, he slipped. There was a slip.
Seven,
the Indian player.
9-13.
Forward here. Yeah, there was the slip. Well, one of two players from India to win the Indian Open. Was just a couple of years ago, not just saying, but he had a shock defeat yesterday. Oh, challenge here. Former champion lost out to teammate Rajawat.
There's a good picture of Kashyap. Constantly working, constantly talking.
Come on the line.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 14-9. Play.
Oh, what a deception.
Isn't that so sweet?
Service over.
That's a
10,
gorgeous shot.
14.
Always a sign the singles player is in trouble. With the back to the net, they can't get their spatial awareness and they can't see what their opponent's doing.
If you master it well, then you can afford to stand far forward and overcome the front court, so it's super important to be able to master these shots.
Service over 15-11.
Service
over.
You can see both players
15
with some nasty deceptions from the front court. Heard each other here, but think about if it was in fast playing conditions, that would be a devastating shot to get to.
Only 2 points the deficit.
15.
My feeling is that the Cheuk Yiu can be mostly satisfied with just trailing by two. Good shot.
It's wide.
Oh, yeah, oh. He's taking it.
Oh, he's going to challenge that. I saw that as in two
seconds.
My judge calling it out. So if he's wrong here, he's got no challenges left. But I don't know with you, Steve. I thought that was on the line.
Maybe not plumb on, but I definitely think it touched.
I think it was plumb on the line. Here we go. We'll be told for sure. You're right, Steve. I just touched the line.
Correction in.
But no doubt it was in.
14, 15.
1 point in it now. Longest rally so far, only 25 shots.
Coach, do not coach when the players are in the game.
Yeah, this time it was catch up. It was told off.
Missed it.
So it's over.
That goes down as a missed opportunity.
Kidambi. Do not show your feet to your opponent. Do not show your feet to your opponent.
Not showing your fist to your opponents. Taken as a sign of or gesture of aggression. Well taken.
Consistent, play more of the good ones.
Playing back to the nets, could only be guilty of backing off and then played the net shot. So once again, just 1 point in it. Turn of serve. Missed it. And for the first time in this opening game, goes into the lead. He's been trailing all the way. Use of the body smash,
it is.
It? 19, 17.
Towards the end of the game, clever play by Lee.
amazing defense.
Oi!
Brilliant! What a rally! And what a way to bring up game point opportunities on a run of six straight points. Look at that defense! Absolutely superb.
Players back onto the court.
And he's not looking too happy. That's understandable. Kidambi looked to be doing so well. 49 up in this opening game.
Subscorer 18-20.
Looked in total control until 17. Mm.
Oh. Amazing defense initially. So two game points have been brilliantly saved by Kidambi.
19-20.
Opportunity for Cheuk Yiu in just a moment. What an opening game. No sign of emotion from one to the hand.
Thank you.
Opening game.
Fantastic drop shot from each of you.
22. Guys missed it.
23-22.
So it will be a fifth opportunity to close out the open game for me, Cheuk Yiu.
Srikanth, throw that ball.
Yeah. Kashaks has calmed down. Easier said than done.
Srikanth, back in the ball.
Disguise and on his
first game on my lead, Cheuk Yiu, 24-22,
having been 5 points adrift at 9-14, and then 3 points adrift at 14-17. It's not how you start, it's how you finish at 24-22. Well, it was a wonderful comeback in the opening game by me, Cheuk Yiu. Question, of course, Steve, what does Kidambi do now? Psychologically, he must have taken a bit of a blow.
I think so too. I think no matter who ended up losing that first game, must be very disappointed. Not having opportunities. But he's playing with the drift, which we know that he can do. So he's just going to get out there and take courage from the fact that he wasn't dying straight last week, and he managed to overcome it. And I think that trying to control the rallies is still the best way for him. I think Cheuk Yiu even started on his way back when he became a bit more interested in attacking and controlling in that first game.
After this rally, if you watch, he immediately turns to his coaches. We couldn't see that, but he did turn to his coaches as if to sort of say, what do I try now? Well, don't try that.
I oftentimes see players when winning such a mentally tight game that they need some time to get back. But that would be the Cheuk Yiu then, and he's sort of racing away here.
Yeah, that was, well, I'm not even sure if you call it a half smash.
That was sort of like a neutralizing shot, saying, you do what you want, see if you can do it. I think it's a perfectly good way for each of you to proceed, because I mean, if you play Srikanth, you don't want to let him control the rallies and attack you. You want to be controlling him and make him move, play from below the tape.
Service over, 6-2.
Something nasty, because he really is beginning to lose his way here. What do you as a coach say to a player when obviously when we're sitting off court we can see what's happening, you know, psychologically more than playing wise? Do you get them to focus on one thing, or do you just try and encourage them?
I don't know. I simply don't know. It depends. Sometimes it seems like a lost cause, and I'm not sure what I would say to Srikanth here. What could he do? Sometimes you have a better knowledge, and you know there's some things that you're working on and so on. Perhaps try to draw from what happened last week when he came back. But it's also because, I mean, I've seen Srikanth for a number of years now, so it's not an option to try and sort of run with Lee Cheuk Yiu. That's just not his style.
No.
So maybe try to do things a little bit better, take a little bit extra time in between the rallies, something, come up with some idea, but now it's almost hopeless. Because he's so far behind.
And it's the way he's got so far behind, because there's been error after error after error.
Like when Lee Cheuk Yiu started his move, it was like this, and then when he fell behind 17-20, he actually played well.
Yeah.
He played like when he was at his best. Threaded it down the line and stuff.
Challenge here.
Called out.
I think that was just wide. Yeah, looking for the giant screen, yes, it's behind you.
Gobichan who's directing.
Yeah.
I think one thing maybe.
Oh no! It wasn't. That's a great challenge. Challenge to the mid-game interval. With a huge advantage. A 9-point advantage, having already won the first. And this is a fairly desperate situation now for Kidambi.
11-2.
So a game and 11-2 up. New champion of Hong Kong, China. Oh, that's a brilliant X shot from Kidambi. Well, he needs a few more of those to get himself back into this second game. Take a look at this. Wow.
I thought a little bit more about this, and one of the things that if Gobichan has an idea, then he could try and sort of convey it to Srikanth now, and it's got to be Gobichan directing, because obviously Srikanth hasn't got an idea himself. So one of them could be to go closer to the net, one of them could be to put pressure on a certain corner of Lee Cheuk Yiu, what they've identified as the weaker corner. If they don't have a read on that, then the idea could be to get a read and ask him to try something, even something a little bit crazy. So just to, if we're short of ideas, then we need to get some ideas, and we don't get them by doing the same over and over again.
Yeah, that's nice. That's what he was doing in the early stages.
5-12.
Shot again.
And the danger for Lee Cheuk Yiu is that he becomes a little bit too content too early.
Yeah.
Go on.
He played a great match, Lee Cheuk Yiu, in Denmark, even though he lost to Victor Axis, and not in Denmark, it was in Malaysia. He played a great match there in the was it the quarterfinal he ended up losing?
No, it was the second round.
Second round. But he won the first game and played two extra points in the second.
That's right.
This one eventually losing three. Good defense from Srikanth.
Yeah, Kidambi forced to change direction.
And that was the shot that Lee Cheuk Yiu won the first game on. And just before that, Wong Chun Han, he called it in terms of shadow movements. He showed with his right hand what kind of shot he was to use. That's clever. That's a good read by Wong Chun Han.
I was just watching some of his defensive shots in that rally, Steve. The man from Hong Kong, China. It was absolutely delightful. He looked so relaxed in the way he hits the shuttle.
Thank you.
Longest rally so far. 32 shots. Body language.
And there was some signs in the previous rally as well, even though he ended up losing it, that he was sort of letting loose again.
Yeah.
Missed it.
Only 6 points adrift. Considering he was 9 points adrift that he came into it.
Yeah.
Super shot. Yeah, yeah. He just cut across it.
Exactly.
Yeah. Certainly not a double hit.
Almost the table tennis serve. That's a badminton shot.
It's loose. Oh, my goodness. He's okay. Missed it.
Yeah,
he'd done so much, so right earlier in the rally.
Yeah, that could be the decisive rally. 11-15 in momentum.
Yeah.
If he'd won it.
Instead of which, he'd 16-10. We're talking about some of the deception at the front of the court.
Thank you. Okay, Srikanth, keep your towel here.
Surface, but they could obviously, both the players could see it.
Yeah, I saw out of the corner of my eye in one of the previous matches and called dirt three to the left. I saw Vitasan slip, champion.
Oh, that's a good shot. Short. Oh, that's delightful.
17.
Disguised drop that got the net caught. When he goes up for this one, he opens his shoulders. Looks as if he's going to play the hard smash. And then the delicate little drop. That's lovely. Away. and all of a sudden this is really believable again as far as Srikanth is concerned. Only 4 points in it. Points away, mini Cheuk Yiu from the place in the second round. Oh! I don't believe it! What a sensational net exchange! That is extraordinary.
19-13.
I really hope we get that from the net cam to see how close it is. Wow.
It seemed to crawl up the net before going over. Just extraordinary.
Thank you. Players back out of the box.
Two points away from the second round. Point opportunities for me to check.
20, match point 13.
That's gone long.
Game.
First time of asking. And the former champion, Kidambi Srikanth, is beaten by Lee Cheuk Yiu here in the first round in 2024. Coming back from that deficit in the opening game, Lee Cheuk Yiu, I think that was really the turning point of the match. 14-17 down to 20-17 up. Although Kidambi forced extra points in the opening game. So Lee Cheuk Yiu safely through to play against the defending champion. And that is Kunlu Tudasan, the reigning world champion in the second round tournament. Confirmation of the scoreline, 24-22, 21-13 in the second game in a match lasting 47 minutes. welcome back to Delhi, day two of competition here at the YONEX Sunrise India Open. Two more matches to come, and next up we've got women's doubles, and it's the number two seeds.